Hey guys, John from FlyMikeAlpha.com. Today we're in a DA-42 and we're going to go through our startup checklist and departure checklist as well as our normal takeoff procedures. So, we've got our pre-flight check completed, our bags and tow bar are secure, aux pumps are off, fuel selectors are on, safeties are in place, power levers are idle, parking brake is set, alternate air is closed, fuel pumps are off, our manual gear extension handle is pushed, gear selector is down, avionics master is off, electric master is off, engine masters are both off, we've got pitot heat is turned off, alternate static is closed, check that right underneath here, and the alternators are both turned on, voter switches are set to auto for our ECUs. All light switches are off. Emergency switch is off and guarded. ELT is armed. And circuit breakers are all checked in over here. Flap selector is up. The electric master will go ahead and turn on. We can hear our gear pump cycling, just recharging the pressure in the system to hold our landing gear down. Rudder pedals are adjusted. Flight controls will check here. All good. Trims, set, takeoff. Gear warning lights and fire detector test. And we're looking for the annunciators up there. All good. Go ahead and enter there. And we'll skip our de-icing since we're down in Florida and it's very hot. We won't be using that today. Flaps, full travel. We're going to check all the way down and all the way up. Our flaps are all the way down. And we're going to bring our flaps all the way up. Up on the left and coming up on the right. Control stick, we're going to go full aft and hold it back. Power levers, we're going to max, and we're going to feel the trim limiter basically push us forward. We're going to go power levers idle and feel the control stick coming back. Kind of a neat system there. It limits you, the idea being that you won't go into a trim stall on takeoff if you've been using a lot of nose up trim to come in and land, that it'll actually limit the travel of the elevator on takeoff. All right, passengers, we don't have any day to instruct. Seatbelts fastened, rear door is closed and latched, front canopy, we're gonna go ahead and leave it here for now. We'll close it after we start up. G1000 is powered up and acknowledged. MFD, we're checking our fuel, quantity, and temperature. We're all good there. Total time and service is noted already, and we're deferring the de-ice check. Start key is inserted, power levers are idle. ACL strobe, we're gonna turn that on. And engine start procedure right down here. Engine master, we're going to turn on. We're going to start with the left engine first. Check in annunciators for the left engine. All looks good. No glow indication. We're clear to start. Clear left. And that's simple. Left engine started up. We're going to do the same exact thing now for the right engine after we check our oil pressure. All good. Oil temperature is looking good. And checking our voltage and amperage. All good. Go ahead and turn our right engine master on. Check for annunciators. All looks good. We'll go ahead and start the right. Clear right. And we're checking oil pressure's up. Temperatures are looking good. Amperage is looking good on the alternators. All set. There we are. Canopy's closed and latched. Little fancy sunshade snowed. RPM is 710. Fuel pumps are off. Fuel selectors, we're going to go ahead and put into crossfeed and check that the crossfeed works. Pitot heat on, and we're going to look for the annunciators. Annunciators go off, then we're looking for an annunciator to come on to let us know that we'll have a stall heat fail. It's limited to 50% when we're on the ground. We'll turn those back off. Avionics master, we can turn on. We'll plug in our headset. And we'll set up our FMS. Alright, FMS is set up, autopilot test. We're gonna go ahead and test that. We're gonna put it in heading mode, watch the stick move. Good. And we'll go ahead and put it in altitude mode. Vertical speed. Nose up. Autopilot's working. And we'll disconnect the autopilot. Floodlights don't need them. Position lights don't need them. Altimeters. Oh, fuel selectors first. We're going to put back to on. And then we'll set our altimeters. Just set them to field elevation here. We don't actually have an altimeter setting for this airport since our AWOS is down. And transponder mode and code is set. Engine temperatures are looking good. Parking brake won't release. And we'll go ahead and use only 50% until all the engine temperatures come up for taxi. Next thing's gonna be before takeoff, we'll do that when we're out there. It takes a good little amount of power to get her rolling, and once she's rolling, you can throttle on back. Checklist, parking brake, we're going to set. Seat belts are fastened, seats and just left. Backrest is upright. Rear doors closed and latched, front canopy is closed and latched. The front baggage doors are closed and latched. Door warning light is off, so this caution is all about just the stall heat, you know, heat is off. That's okay, we're going to take off with it off. Electric elevator trim is checked and set to takeoff position. Fuel selectors are checked both on, rudder trim is as required, neutral, and flaps are checked up. Flight controls, check them one more time. Nothing's fallen during taxi to bind up our flight controls. All good. And power levers are idle. FMD, all the system looks good over there. And we'll go ahead and check our border switches. Left engine is running on ECU A, it seems. And ECU test, we're going to go ahead and take care of that now. Just by pressing and holding these two buttons here. Always behind us. Transponder code mode set, fuel pumps will turn on, and landing light will turn on since we're about to enter the runway. All our frequencies are set up here, all good. Venice traffic, Twinstar, 417-10-0, Venice. Thank you. guys, thanks so much for watching, and thank you so much for sharing us on Facebook, Twitter, and all the other social media sites. If you have any questions about the video at all, just leave them in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Be sure to give us a thumbs up on our video, and you can subscribe to us to keep up with all our latest episodes right over here on the right. Also, check out some of these other helpful videos below, and remember, if you can't fly every day, then fly at mikealpha.com. We'll see y'all next time.